good morning. Welcome to the stream, everyone. It is me, your e-daddy, Rotten Poppy, back again for another stream. Today, I'm going to be getting into a surprise cosplay. If you're subscribed to my fan house, you already know this one, I think, so just don't spoil it for the rest of us. And, yeah. Then we got a Bob Ross speed paint, and then we got Metroid Prime. That's the itinerary for today. And this is what's up. So, yeah, I'm going to be doing my makeup. This is what I look like. This is so weird. This is my first time wearing green color contacts, or even wearing, like, just, like, seeing myself with a different color eye that's, like, a natural color eye, and it's weird as fuck. This is weird.
Who is that? Who is that?
Not me. I don't even fucking know who that is. I never met that person. Don't know her. Super fucking weird. Anyway, hello. Alright, wow. Oh, people are hyped today. This is good news. I like your guesses, by the way. They're very funny. Alright, gonna put that music like that. I wonder if anyone will guess it. I'm not gonna say, even if someone says it. You guys will just have a review then. So, but yeah, the contacts are weird, right? I remember when I was 13, I really wanted green eyes. And I said that to a couple people, and they told me that it would be really weird because brown eyes are such a defining feature of mine, and they're absolutely right. I don't know this person. Who the fuck is that? Anyway, we're gonna be doing my makeup. Also, don't mind, I know my dark circles are, you know what? I don't know why I'm telling you this, but to me, I look a little more tired than usual. Probably not to you, probably I noticed. But, I actually had to take my cat to the vet last night. Pog? Not Pog. He has a UTI. He's fine. He's just on antibiotics now. But poor boy. Poor boy, I was up late taking him to the vet. Poor boy. Yeah, he's okay. He's fine. He's just on antibiotics. Just to say that's great, Zodi. Let's see. Good pacing. Yay! Oh, good job, Zodi! Good job! Perfect. Thank you so much. I'm going to take a thumbnail. I meant to do it last night, but I'm going to have to take the thumbnail picture. Probably not when I'm in cosplay, when I get out of cosplay. Which, the whole process will be process putting it on, taking some of it off. It'll be easy clap, don't worry. But yeah, I'm excited. Okay. Yeah, Prince is fine. He's okay. Good news is that when they checked his urinalysis, because that's what they did, because they suspected a UTI, obviously, is that his glucose and his concentration were good, which means that it looks like his kidneys and his sugar levels are good, which means that he does not have a problem with his kidneys or problem with diabetes, most likely, which is great because he's 12. So that's when those problems kind of start to happen. And he's a pretty healthy boy. He just got a UTI. Fucking fed him dry food for like 3 days. For like 3 days, I fed him dry food and he gets a UTI. This boy. This poor boy. He needs the wet food. Otherwise, he gets dehydrated, I guess. He's got tier cute kidneys. He's Mr. Kidney. Oh, Raven. Oh, you know what? Thank you for gifting that sub to Organelle, and I think I heard Raven, thank you for gifting that sub to King Todd and to Askindu. Sorry if I said that wrong. Thank you so much for gifting those subs. You just gave the best emotes to somebody. That's yeah, it sucked. Well, I took him to the vet at like 8. And then they didn't give me him back till 11:30. And you're not allowed to go in there, but also I wasn't sure how long, like, it... So my friend and I just ended up sitting in the fucking parking lot for 3 hours. And that felt bad. And then, yeah. It was not very poggers. I feel really bad for my friend that waited for so long with me. Because she didn't know that it was going to be that long. I didn't know that it was going to be that long. So... But that's okay, because next weekend I'm going to see her, and I'm going to take her on a picnic or to the zoo, depending on the weather. And it's like a very big, spacious outdoor zoo, no crowding. So don't worry. Fine, I see. And if I realize it's not fine, then I won't go. But, then we'll do. But I feel like that'll make it up to her. Poor little baby. Have you thought of getting him a kitty? He has a kitty fountain. He got a UTI like 4 or 5 years ago almost. Actually, it must have been around 5-ish years ago, or like 4.5 years ago, because I know I wasn't streaming yet. And so I got him a kitty fountain. I'm like super diligent about cleaning his litter box. I feed him expensive wet food. I do everything in my fucking power basically so that this wouldn't happen again. But then I fed him dry food thinking like, okay, he's been doing really good. I think it won't hurt him to have a couple of days where he just eats dry food in between me going to the store to buy him some wet food. And I was fucking wrong. Turns out I was wrong for that. Thank you, Doc Inquiris, for the Prime sub, bitch! Prime sub, motherfucker! Yeah, thank you. I hope that you enjoy those emotes. The best on Twitch. You guys didn't know, if you have Amazon Prime, connect that to Twitch, get a free sub to this place. Yeah, he's okay. He's okay. Yeah, and he's taking, so far, I've only had to give him 2 antibiotics so far, but he has taken them really well, which is great. Last time he had a UTI, I had to give him I had to shoot like a little syringe thing like in the back of his throat, and he was like very aggressive, didn't like that. He would smack it out of my hand. Hype train chugging. What? Thank you, Bacon! Yo, hype train! Motherfucker! So, and he did not like to take his pills. I remember it was very difficult to get him to take his pills. But this time, he's not really fighting me too much on it yet. He might clue in and decide to fucking hate it at some point in the next. But he's gonna. But we'll see. So far, he's been doing really good, and then after he takes his pill, I feed him treats. 1, to make sure he swallows it, and 2, to make him associate it with a good thing. Whoa! Thank you for the year, Romeo Reds! That's so sweet of you! 1 fucking year? Such a long time!
Your stream where you showed off your men's jean inspired me to get women's jeans.
Really? I'm wearing men's jeans today too. They're different kind. They're different ones. But yay! I hope that they make you feel super comfortable and that you like them. That makes me so happy. Oh, that's great. Because women's jeans fit nice, right? Like, I've known some men who wear women's jeans. They have as many pockets? No, but they have really big pockets. They're long, so I can hold my whole phone in it, which is nice. Okay. Will you guys judge me if I eat dry ramen as a snack during the stream? No, do it. Uncle Scott wears a women.
Hype, move for oop.
Thank you for the bits, Andalos! Surprise cosplay hype! Surprise cosplay hype! All good.
Surprise cosplay hype.
Oh, there it is. Only slightly. Slightly isn't bad. If you guys start roasting, I don't know if I'll handle it well. It's been a great year. Thanks for all the fun content. I'm so happy you like it. Hardhead, thank you for extending your subscription through to fucking May. Hell yeah, thank you so much. And that leveled up the fucking hype train. Ooh. Ooh. Oh boy. Okay. I'm trying to make sure I don't get makeup on my contacts. That would be a bummer. Yo! And that's 2 months too, Hardhead. Thank you so much. I'm super stoked I caught you live. Hi! Welcome to the stream.
I'm doing my makeup.
Fuck.
I need to look at my reference photo, which I will not show you. Hopefully as it comes together, you'll see. But it's a pretty, you know what else I will say? Character is pretty fucking random. So there is a chance that some of you guys won't know the fucking character. So, and you know what? I'm okay with that. That's a risk I'm willing to.
Hi, Pope Frank.
Man, I used to love Kirby's Epic Yarn. I beat that game 100%.
Yo, thanks for the bits. Saw your Scott Pilgrim cosplay and followed on Twitter and then saw you were live. That makes me so happy. I'm so glad you like that cosplay. I'm very proud of it. I'm very proud of it. I've been debating posting it to Reddit, but Reddit people are mean to me sometimes, so I've been scared. It's a nice phone case. Thank you. It's cute, but it's not very protective if you drop your phone away. A pro tip from the dad here, because it's like very squishy. So if I'll show you an example. Like it doesn't, it's not very stuck on. So I need a different one for going outside. I was wondering what was different by your eyes. And also I referred a friend to your channel today. Ooh, a friend. Your eyes, Lalo, and also, I referred a friend thank to you your so channel much. Today, Daddy. Yeah, I'm wearing color contacts. Oh.
It's freaky!
You're the first person I ever tried subscribing to, but couldn't figure it before.
Aww. That's so cute, hot chocolate. Thank you.
I think it has a specific... Well, some people on Reddit are really cool. It's just occasionally... I think that the mean people on Reddit are really mean. Kind of like Twitter. Twitter has that audience too. But it feels easier because you can, like, I have followers on Twitter, so I know my followers will see it first. Whereas Reddit, I'm just, like, throwing it into the abyss and going, be nice, please! Like, it just... the more of a gamble, but I'm still probably gonna do it. I just need to work up the courage. Where the fuck is my eyebrow shit?
What? What?
Oh, it's right there. Okay, I found it. Should have posted that shit as soon as you shot it, Poppy. You're probably right. Probably right. I mean, the only reason I posted my pink Ramona Flowers cosplay onto Reddit is because someone else did first. And then it started getting attention, and then people told me about it. I was like, oh, you didn't credit me. And then they were like, oh, I'll take it down and you should post it. And then that's what happened. But it feels like a Twitter without a personality. I kind of agree with that statement. I mean, no hate to Reddit users. I know lots of people who use Reddit that are cool as fuck, but... Do you ever get the Insta thing taken down? No. That's just living there right now. Fog. Eyebrow looking kind of fly today, actually. Look at that. That's... it's never that easy. Have you started the new season of Fruits Basket? You mean season 2? Or is there season 3 that came out? Did season 3 start coming out? I don't know if I'll watch it periodically or binge it all. But I bet it only take 10 minutes. Maybe. Say hi to me. Hi, Mega Man! Thank you guys so much! For the hype train. I really appreciate that. Yeah, I'm definitely more of a Twitter person than a Reddit person. But... I appreciate what Reddit has done. That, I mean, put me on Google search. JB! 20 months! Holy fuck, man. Thank you so much. no, 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 no.
Also, who would you cosplay Mortal Kombat? Probably also Katana. I know that Candyline's doing a sick Katana cosplay. I don't think I will cosplay Katana, but if I were to choose a character, it'd also be Katana, because that's the only character I really like. What? No. Yeah. But, that said, check out Candyline cosplay if you don't know her, because she's doing a sick as fuck Katana cosplay that you will love and adore.
Weep. Wee weep weep.
Wee. I don't know if I'm gonna watch it. Do you think it'll be good? Do you think it'll be worth it? Maybe I'll watch it. Maybe I'll watch it just cause gamer moment. I'm trying to figure out what my next step should be. Fucking song. So emotional. Why is it so emotional? It's so beautiful. Yeah, Rainy. Crazy. The surprise cosplay is a surprise. Oh, time for eyeshadow. I probably should have. Fucking base. That, and that'll take care of it. But yes, the Grotto theme. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it. Oh, good. I'm so excited for Breath of the Wild 2. Hope that comes out soon. I mean, if it doesn't, I'm not gonna hate, you know. I understand that video game delays exist, but I hope it comes out soon. I really liked it a lot, you know? You know? Check out the Mortal Kombat movie today? I didn't. I don't know if you're asking me if I will. Maybe I. Ramen break. Ramen. Watch Annihilation, and apparently it was not edited properly. That's why many characters different film. Oh, interesting. Nicely. I just discovered you on TikTok a few minutes ago. Something kept turning into knives. My first time being here. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you, Geoff. Thank you for coming to the stream. I'm glad that you liked that video. Seems like people really liked that one. Which makes me happy. Because I was not expecting it to really get views. I thought it would just be like a funny throwaway. But then people liked it. So that's Pogs. That's Pogs. Not cooperate. Yeah, some people said I was cheating because I colored out people's faces. But if you don't block off their faces, then it doesn't give you a different character. Like, it literally just won't. So you have to color their faces in. Certified funny. It was certified a funny tweet. As Twitter said themselves. Certified comedy. Okay. This should fill me up. I don't know why I love eating dry ramen so much. I think I like it because it's really easy to eat. It was amazing, especially when I became Michael Cera. I became him so many times. Unacceptable. Why'd that filter do me like that? I got did by that filter.
got it right on the first time. That doesn't happen to me very often. One time I called a guy named Dylan Dylon for like a really long time and refused to stop, basically. Couldn't get it right. No matter how much they told me that their name was Dylan, I kept on calling them Dylon, so. But I can get Geofmetry, so woo! Thank you, Brother Bluto, for the raid. Welcoming raiders. Hi, I'm Rotten Poppy. I'm a retro variety streamer here on Twitch. I like Nintendo games. And right now I'm doing my makeup and going into a surprise cosplay. And also gonna eat some dry ramen, because I'm hungry. Kirkman County Line, apparently Instagram is threatened to delete her account. I love her content. Oh, really? Oh no. Instagram has been threatening to delete a lot of people's accounts lately, I noticed. I feel like there's a glitch. Or maybe people are reporting or abusing the report button. The TikTok was hilarious. Thank you. You guys are making me feel so special. I feel so funny and special today. Thank you. What are they claiming Candyline did? It's, I think it was a threat. I can't remember. But it was, I know that one of her Instagram stories got taken down for inciting violence because she said she wanted to fight whoever made the pants that she was sewing. Like, it just, like, misunderstood that. And then, what else happened? I know it happened to Emma Langevin and to Hazely. Because the fuck did they post? It was like the same thing where they posted a story and it got taken down for like being violent or something, but they weren't doing anything. Abby's the only person on TikTok that takes lip sync serious. It's an art form. I do try to lip sync like properly when I lip sync. I remember when I did the Ramona T one, which was like forever ago. I lip synced that and a bunch of people thought it was actually me saying it. Because I also uploaded the audio. That was very poggers. I felt really good about that because I practiced and practiced and practiced. I missed you. You haven't streamed. I streamed yesterday, and I streamed on Tuesday, and I streamed on Monday, and I streamed on the Friday before that, and I streamed on the Thursday before that, and I streamed on the Tuesday before that. Don't count. They're just gonna keep spanning. All right, sounds good to me. Thanks, Rainy. These are color contacts. My brown eyes are better than, I think. Suit me better. Suit me better. No shade to green eyed people. Green eyes are fucking awesome. But on me, brown eyes. Yo, calzone! Yum. I'm just eating some ramen because I'm hungry. And I'm gonna start getting aggressive. I'm gonna start getting really aggressive if I don't eat. Try ramen. So good. Yeah, it really changes my face. Like, I look like a different person completely with different color eyes. It's weird. It's weird. The people who told me that green eyes would be weird on me when I told them I wanted green eyes when I was 13 were correct. Like, why is it so different? You're like, who is that? I'd like to see blue, black, and maybe purple. I have blue and purple contacts as well, so we're gonna try those. That's what my friend said. Oh, right, captions. I have that set up to turn on. There we go. So when I was 13, I told my friend that I was like trying to manifest green eyes essentially. Because my sister said that she used to have brown eyes and then they turned green because she said she really wanted green eyes. So that I was like, I can do that. So So I said that to a friend of mine, and she was like, whoa, if you had green eyes, like, you wouldn't even be Adrian. Like, that would be weird. And it, like, that really hit me. I was like, wow, like, my brown eyes are such a big feature of mine that it would, like, change me. Like, I would seem so different. Then after that, I really liked my brown eyes. I'm the evil version of Poppy. Fake Gamer Guy. Thank you, Shadow, for gifting that sub to Fake Gamer Guy. Wallaby, would you still be called Woppy? Yeah. Yeah, now I can change my identity at snap of my fingers. Go in public with color contacts on, no one will even recognize me. All I need to do is put on one of my wigs. Boom. Brand new bitch. What flavor? Ramen flavor. The stream's available for replay? Yes, you can watch VODs offline. They're not on YouTube, but they're on, if you go to videos and then past broadcasts, you can watch. You won't get to talk in the chat, but you can still observe. I really need to start uploading my VODs onto YouTube. I'm gonna buy wigs and contacts, feel like it's five. Love the Super Smash. How do you guys, okay, Smash friends, how did you feel about Super Smash Bros. Brawl? I'm curious. Because I tried to replay it a while ago and I didn't really like it, but I really liked it when it came out. But I think Melee is superior. I was in middle school. Fun game, good adventure, slow fight. Yeah, the adventure is interesting. I like that. But Melee, my true love. Yo! Thank you so much for 6 months of being sub, Gold Tiger! Happy, happy year! Melee will always reign supreme. I agree. Objectively isn't the best. Okay. But how did you feel about the Wii U version of Smash Bros? Do you roller skate? I'm actually learning how to roller skate right now. I just bought a pair a couple weeks ago. It snowed though, but now it's melted, so I don't think I'll have time to roller skate this weekend, but probably next weekend I will. I like the Wii U version. I really did. I played it once. No story mode, the weird me thing. Oh, you know what? I never did the online on the Wii. Is that true? Crazy with it in college? Really? Outlook good on Smash Wii U, alright. Guess I have an unpopular opinion. Maybe I didn't play it enough. I love Stardew Valley. Yeah, I did all the community bundles. Didn't like go through it all the way, but I thought about doing a playthrough where I try to date all the characters at once. Ranking of ultimate is just very unnecessary, it feels. Plus, you're locked in a character. I'm going a few rounds with people. Yeah, I see what you mean. Abigail. I fucking love Abigail. I know that's the basic bitch response, but she's a classic. You can't go wrong. Very good. Oh man, I also love Lee. I love Lee too. Those are my two faves. Lee and Abigail are literally like my waifus for laifus. I mean, pretty much all of the girls in that game are really good though. Like, all of them. I feel like Emily, I need to get to know Emily. I feel like we would get along. Abigail's the basic bitch response because it's the correct response, true. Kiki, good to see you, hi! What is, and dry ramen fills you up so nicely. It's such a good snack. Abigail's best. I like Haley after her six heart. And I would do things to George, but he's taken. George. Yeah. That one guy that lives in the sewer? I want to play the mod where I can date him. That's a true guy. But, yeah, Haley, I haven't gotten a chance to meet yet. Like, I actually do kind of want to go through. Wait, listen to this fucking song.
Gonna find more places than just he need to rub peppers.
Oh my god. The realm of possibility? Yes. Yes, it would. I got a couple games coming up that aren't Stardew Valley, but it is something that you might. Abigail's heart events are also cute. Yeah. I love her. I love her. Okay. I bit myself. I don't know, Mega Man. But it does. It's so good. Man, I love Luigi. Are there like Luigi's Mansion mods? Like, is there like a mod for Luigi's Mansion that makes it into a new game? Am I allowed to play that? I'm gonna play that. Still eating dry ramen? Yes. Listen, I asked chat if they would judge me for eating dry ramen, and most of them said no. Except for the ones that didn't talk. Floppy is probably my green contact. Mario 64 is a Chaos Edition engine? What is that? Hot Chocolate did say that it's slightly good. Okay, I'm gonna...
The only dude I knew that ate dry ramen also ate uncooked hot dogs out of the fridge in a single bite. Between that and the kombucha monkers.
Is that the same guy? I mean, I like dry ramen. It's good. It's a good snack. And also, when I ate meat, I did eat uncooked hot dogs. And I'm not really proud to admit that, but it's true. I did. And apparently they're pre-cooked, so you can eat them raw. And this isn't my fault, okay? Because this was generational, all right? This was generational. And not my fault. I would personally not do that now, but I was a child. Keep in mind that I was also 14 when I went vegetarian, so before that, I was still a child. However, I remember vividly one night, I was chilling in my parents' bedroom, and I was watching TV because they had a TV in their bedroom, and my dad came in after going to the store, and he put his jacket on me, and so that I could be warm because I wasn't tucked under the covers for whatever reason. And then I asked him if I could have a snack, and then he went downstairs and he came back up and he gave me 2 uncooked hot dogs. And I said to him, is this okay to eat? And he said, yes, they're pre-cooked. And then I ate them. And then it was a snack that I would have occasionally until I became vegetarian.
So the cold mystery meat collected from the floor is amazing.
And then what? I don't remember.
And that's why her name is Rotten Paki La La La.
That's why her name is Rotten Paki. Trying to get back at my dad for feeding me uncooked hot dogs and make me think that was an appropriate snack.
Thanks, Retro Reaper.
Alright, back to makeup. Back to makeup. I ate enough ramen. How do you frozen pizza sandwiches? Wait, like, still frozen? Ultimate irony, hot dogs are cold. Yeah, actually. I eat hot dogs most days of my childhood. Hot dogs are a surefire way to make me. Like me with bananas for some reason. Bananas make me. Oh my god! Mario Party 8! Man. I do have some nostalgia for Mario Party 8. Not gonna lie. I know that Mario Party 8 is considered when the Mario Party franchise, like, started going downhill, and that's true. And that is true. Okay? That is facts. But, it's still pretty fun. It's actually, compared to the other shit they started doing after Mario Party 8, it's not actually that bad.
It's still not enough, though, Daddy Glum.
True, Beer Good. That's actually a thing that happened. Like an alternate reality version of yourself. I'm used to brown eyes. That's actually true because my mom and my sister have green eyes. So in an alternate reality, I could have green eyes. That's true. That would have been like a gene that was possible to be passed down to me, but fucking wasn't. But you know what? Color contacts exist. And I actually like my brown eyes better than. Been a nice revelation. Ooh. This reality is better. I agree. Something don't feel right. Something don't feel right. I think I got something in my eye. I think I'm okay. I think my contact just moved to an uncomfortable position. Yeah. Rotten Poppy, famous Knives lookalike streamer, that's me. Looking just like Knives. We'll see. If there's any pain, I will take them out immediately, but I think we're okay. Or even any irritation beyond what I'm feeling. I think I just had a moment where I realized I was wearing contacts and it felt like I was wearing contacts, you know? I'm just worried that, you know, what's that thing that you have that where one eye, where you're not supposed to wear contacts because you have a certain thing? What is that called? Like, what if I develop one of them randomly?
Here's your ASMR slurp. Mad Lad Adam!
Stigma, yeah. Like, what if I developed a stigma? Develop a stigma or are you born with a stigma? I had glasses, I got LASIK, never wore contacts, just stick that stat. Honestly, respect. Developed? Okay. Well, guess I'll find out the hard way. Too late now. Maybe we'll get to do eye patch stream. It's funny now, but it's not funny. Okay, it's fine. Okay, that looks pretty good. I'll just make it, I think what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna do my makeup in a way that I like. Color? Look right. It's pronounced jizmatism. Ah, of course. How could I not pronounce it the proper way? Jizmatism. Thank you for letting me know. My mom went viral when she got something in her eye during cosplay stream and ran screaming. Oh. Hog. I'll be on MS Paint. Yes. And it looked really pretty. So then on TikTok, her followers convinced her to like the other eye to look like that, and it was very pretty. Well, cause she actually got to match it on the other eye pretty well, and it didn't. If I ever get a black eye, I want it to look like that. Now sketch. Oh, you're the best. That's perfect. I actually love that. Badass cosplay incoming. So true. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you for 6 months in a row, Adam McDonald. Okay. Yes, eyeliner time.
Focus. It's eyeliner time.
Whoever made this playlist had the same childhood as me, and I appreciate them. Called like Nintendo songs from my childhood that make me nostalgic or something, and it is working for me very well. Ooh, Doom thinks that it's gonna be Scott Pilgrim himself. So Doom, I hope you're doing good. Good to see you, friend. See you. Well, Hoggers. Yeah, you're free to guess. I won't say if you get it right. So just guess and then you'll get still a couple different steps we have to go through, so. Also, I'm gonna awkwardly have to take my thumbnail photos during because I was gonna do it last night and then I didn't. Also, oh, I tried the Impossible Whopper last night for the first time. Finally got it here. I rate it. I mean, it tastes just like how I think a Whopper probably tastes. I never had a Whopper, an actual Whopper before, so I don't fucking know. But I think it was good. Tasted like a fast food burger, which is what it was trying to achieve. I think there's lots of other burgers that are better, but those burgers are also more expensive. So, Impossible Whopper, decent. Decent. Wouldn't probably go out of my way to get an Impossible Whopper, like... No, I don't think I'll ever crave it. But, if my friends are like, oh my god, I want to go to Burger King, then at least I know there's something there that's actually decent. Or if I ever randomly am like, I really want a fast food burger today, then, yeah. Fuck, this eyeliner is so good that it's, like, impossible to get off after you put it down. Only problem I have with this. Ooh, Bulma. Yeah, that's a pretty... Oh, this is coming out good. This... Love curve. Mom is vegan and she's burger at KFC. The vegan burger at KFC is fucking delicious. I would say that one's way better than the Impossible Whopper, to be honest. That's me personally. But like, finding a good like fried chicken substitute as a vegetarian has been pretty hard. And that one just hits. It just hits. I like it a lot, actually. That's been nice, because that's the only thing that I feel like I couldn't find, like, an adequate substitute for. And KFC came through, so thank you. Usually super. Yeah, they've been, well, lately they've been so good. Like, I went vegetarian 9 years ago. It's so different. And it's cool. Oh wait, this seems like the first song I don't recognize on the- I'm gonna drop, then gonna dip, make amazing. So working on my wing sharper. Oh, thank you so much, Gibbs. I hope you're doing good. Thank you so much. 10 months, that's such a long time. Look at you go. DS. Oh, I didn't play Mario Kart DS. That's why. It like sounded vaguely familiar. I'm gonna guess that it was a song from Mario Kart. Alright, that looks so weird. My normal makeup on, God. But pretty, so pretty, but damn, just fuck. It was really fucking weird, almost creepy. It is creepy. I remember I worked with a girl who wore color contacts every day, because I guess she just didn't like her brown eyes very much. I remember thinking that she looked creepy. Oh. My childhood, yeah, that's the opposite. I had Nintendo. Childhood. Natural? Someone? Yeah, I think that's why. Like, I think color contacts also look creepier than actual, like, colored eyes, because there's something, like, that is, like, lifeless about them a little bit. Even if the colors are, like, exactly, like, a natural green, like, this is a very natural-looking green color, but it looks, like, it's just, it looks creepy. Like, there's something about it that makes it look a little unsettling. I mean, usually they look fine in photos, and it's hard to tell, but I think as soon as it's in motion, it, like, Consolus Mega Drive on an N64 PS. Damn. Seasoned gamer. Seasoned gamer. Ninja's at 5 of the motion. Yeah. I think it's the eye dilation, yeah, because eyes are a muscle, obviously, but, like, they fucking, like, they change a little bit, like, they focus on shit, and I think part of it is just that color contacts don't do that, so it just looks off. How do I work out my eyes? I don't, like, a workout eye expert? Very focused on. So weird. Okay. Time for war.
Where's my fucking?
There it is. Enjoy your lurk, Retro Reaper. Good to see you, as always. You guys make your people. Okay. I don't know. Why does it look so funny? My nostrils. Play Kirby's Epic Yarn. Oh my Wii, so I can play it. I should. I actually want to. I 100% of that game. I barely remember it, but I fucking love it. I played it over the course of spring break, and I had a fucking good time. My uncle had an Atari when I was a bit young, actually.
Oh, I understand.
And watch it, I'm blank. Watch it. Never had handhelds as a kid. My parents had an S. Cousin? Oh. Stories like that always fucking upset me because my mom would never
do that.
Happy I have all the you're an orphan. I do now is play it. That's nice. There's so many. Right. Oh, it's because I'm whispering, because I'm focusing. Sorry, guys. Sorry, I don't know what I said. I don't know what I said, I'm sorry. Me and my friends used to rent SNES. Street Fighter on weekends? Oh! I have Street Fighter 3 for my SNES, and it's like the only fighting game I'm actually good at. Well, maybe I'm kind of good at Smash, but like, not pro level. But, and not, I'm not pro level Street Fighter, but I can whoop ass. Are you wearing contacts? I am. Contacts for the cosplay. I'm getting in the cosplay, but I'm also gonna have to take thumbnail pictures. It's gonna be awkward. What? By the way, thank you to all the new followers. Soon we might hit 30k eventually. Your pop. Eyes look really nice. Thank you. Great brush. This one is Revlon Ravishing Rose. That's the color, and it's actually really nice. I'm really surprised, actually. This blush is usually not this pigmented or nice, and it has a bit of a shine to it. I actually really. Oh, yeah. Revlon Ravishing Rose, not bad. I did finish Little Nightmares. Great game. Cosplay's coming together. This is weird. Is she? Especially weird is this is how I do my makeup normally, so it's like extra strange. It looks so different. Probably the most guys watching a girl do her makeup. People like it for some reason. I did not know people would like it as much as they do. As fuck, I love makeup vids. I love watching makeup vids while I'm doing my makeup. It's like a solidarity thing. I'm so nervous. Endgame in Kingdom Hearts 1, crowd mode, but Asim's phase is too harder than Dark Souls. Jack 2 combined. I think I can beat it before Nier Replicant gets here today, too. I'm so excited for that. Ooh, that's exciting. I'm actually gonna get some tips.
It's surprisingly interesting to watch you do makeup and see it all come together at the end.
It's kind of like watching a painting, right? Like, it's very similar. It's like an artistic process, right? Like, where you're like watching something happen, you're like, that looks fucking weird, and then it's like, oh wait, no, that looks good. Where's the place from? I can send you the link. It's a good playlist. It makes me stoked. I try not to rely too heavily on, like, makeup content, because I know that, if I do it every day, it feels, like, lazy, but it's nice. I feel like once a week I want to start, like, nice. That means it's a retro game? Yeah, you could totally play Ace Attorney in the Retro tab if you want to. And if anyone gives you shit about it, you could be like, it's 20 years old, I consider that retro. And there's nothing they can fucking do about it. I've played, like, 15-year-old games in the Retro tab before, too, so. Shrek Vintage? Nah, Shrek is retro. I wouldn't even vintage grab Shrek. That's me personally. Are you wearing contacts? I am right now for this cosplay. Yeah, you can also play just retro style in the retro tab. People will give you shit sometimes, but you can say, fuck them. Literally doesn't matter. People just kind of like to gatekeep. So just gives a shit. Yeah, I'd say 15 years old is good enough to consider it retro. I would say 10 is pushing it. But if it's like 14 years old, round up. Round up. Thanks for linking the playlist. Thanks for liking the playlist. No problem. This looks pretty. I'm excited. I might just like start dabbling with color contacts. Funs. Diablo 2 qualifies as retro? Yes. You could play Diablo 2. Coming together. I feel pretty red now. Yeah, 10 could be classic. Like, Wii games? I play Wii games sometimes in the retro tab. But some Wii games are also 15, 20 years old. Well, maybe not 20. Maybe not 20 years old. How old is the Wii? 10 years old-ish? The Super Gaming was 10 years ago in 2011. So many great. Best year? Yeah. I play Wii games at the retro tab. I don't give a fuck. I don't give a shit. No one's gonna tell me what to do. I've had people give me shit for playing SNES games in the retro tab, as if I need to be fucking playing Atari only. Who gives a fuck? Okay, I'm gonna do a little business. That is gonna seem a little fucking weird, but should work out and come together. I'll have a sip of my drink. That's ridiculous. Usually, and this is just me assuming, but usually people are like, I can't believe this is retro. This isn't retro. And it's like, I just, you know what? Not even an issue. No one's said that to me in a while, so, but yes. Donkey Kong Country 2, was it that I was playing? Have someone game? Like, that's not retro. Back in my day, we used to play the fucking Pong. Like, okay. Okay, so this is brown eyeshadow. I'll explain what I'm doing here, because I'm using brown eyeshadow to enhance the shape of my lips to match the character. Yeah, Donkey Kong Country 2 is like 30 years old. Yeah. I don't know. Gatekeep girl boss. You know how it is. The makeup that gets applied, the more stumped I am. What the fuck is going on? Yeah, understandable, honestly. And the internet has made me realize that I've gotten quite skilled with makeup, which is honestly makes me so happy. Like, 5 years ago, I used to be a, like, mascara, eyeliner, a little bit of eyebrow business. And, like, that was it, I guess. But honestly, working in makeup for that, like, year where I had to do it every day, really actually... I did makeup. And also streaming did a lot. So thank you, Twitch, and thank you to that job that I fucking hated. Sucked, but at least I got some skills. Honestly, if it weren't for getting that job that I thought I would love, that I ended up hating and having to quit because I was like, this job is making me, like, it's killing me. Then I wouldn't even be a streamer, maybe. Well, I maybe would have gotten around to it at some point, but... just quitting that job that got me to start streaming. Crazy how things like that can... You know what's even crazier? The only reason I got that job is because I went to the store in a different location, and I was just, like, really enthusiastic about the store and the products and stuff. Fuck, and then someone that worked at that store was... doing, like, just happened to be there that day and recommended me as an employee. And was like, oh, I saw her before. I remember her. She was really enthusiastic about the products. You should hire her. Which, her good word and just her having observed me and being there that day was the reason I got that job. Because they were like, oh, is she? Like, that's great. Weird. Hi, Ramona. No game is old enough to count as retro. Not even chess. That was around when ye old ancient people invented chess. It can't be retro. What job was it that you hated? So, I worked at a skincare shop called The Body Shop. I have to specify because it sounds like I worked at an auto parts place, but I did not. It was called The Body Shop. And it's like a UK skincare and makeup company. And they make, like, lotions and perfumes and, makeup and all that shit. And, like, they had a really cool policy, which was, like, that they did, like, fair trade, stuff. Like, they had really good ingredients in their stuff and, ethical business practices. Thank you for the bits, Nori. And, so that's why I was stoked. You know, I was like, that seems so awesome. I want this job here so badly. And I was, like, an admin shopper of there for years. And I worked there just after they sold out to L'Oreal. And I don't want to hate on L'Oreal at all. But, like, the way that it was managed was totally different from the core values we were taught. And also, so we had to be in full makeup, like, at least 5 visible pieces of makeup, every shift. So at one point they told me I was not wearing enough makeup, even though I was wearing the minimum 5 pieces. So I started having to do, like, really, more aggressive makeup every day when I came to work, which took time. I had to get, like, getting ready for work, I had to minimum an hour, have to spend an hour on makeup that I wasn't paid for to put on, which was just frustrating. For obvious reasons, that's frustrating. My manager, mostly I think it was my manager herself, my first day working there, she was sleeping in the back. I found her sleeping, just taking a nap. And she was like really weird and manipulative, and like I could have taken them to the labor board for not paying me overtime and like screwing my hours around and changing my schedule 24 hours before stuff. And then when I tried to get another job, they scheduled on top of that other job, and I was like really, really fucking broke. Like I was so broke, and I couldn't have that other job. Like she basically like power tripped and wouldn't let me have it. So, and then I wanted to go to my cousin's wedding, which I'd been trying to get off since I started working there. And then in September, she, like at the beginning of September, she said it was a blackout period and we weren't allowed to book any time off from September till the end of December for Christmas, which isn't even, the blackout period starts in like late November. So I didn't go to my cousin's wedding for a stupid minimum wage job. I'm still upset that I should have just fucking quit when that happened, but I didn't. I picked the job over my cousin's wedding and I fucking hate that. I should have quit and I didn't. So, yeah. And then I had one coworker who was really hard to deal with. She tried to sabotage me. I was trying to get the team lead position because it was a small raise and guaranteed me a little bit more hours. Because like I said, I was really broke and I was working part-time. So my hours were really fucking random. And the bus times are shitty. And it cost me a lot of money to like bus there even because I was making such little money. They would convince me to, so if they didn't make their day... So, for example, if we were $40 short on the day, which, because they have sales goals, right? They would, like, peer pressure you into spending your money to make the day, especially as, like, a team lead. Like, they really wanted me to do that. So, I did that before, but I had... So, one time I worked a 4-hour shift, and then we were $40 short, and I got peer pressured into spending $40, which is what I earned... for that day. So I didn't make any fucking money. And my friend who worked with me, because I actually did make one friend working at that job, was like, don't do that. Just don't give in. Like, when they pressure you, just don't do it. Just don't do it. Like, you can't... That's your entire shift. You can't do that. So, yeah, it was hard. And that's, like I said, that's not the company's fault. It's the management. It's the management's fault. So, again, no shade. The company, I still think that they have good products and everything. I think the transition to being owned by different companies was hard. And they're not owned by L'Oreal anymore. They're owned by, I think, a Brazilian company now. So I have no idea how that's going. But the transition was really rough and they lost a lot of staff. So, yeah. It was hard. Oh, and when I got sabotaged, well, and it didn't work out when she tried to sabotage me, but basically, I was closing with this one girl, and she didn't want the team leader position because she wanted to be assistant manager. She was like, I need to, and so she was trying to, like, steal the assistant manager position from our already assistant manager, which was just fucking weird. But so she wouldn't accept the team lead because she was above that, but, like, didn't climb up. Like, I don't, whatever. So, I was next in line to get it. And so when we were closing together, she was doing tills, and then my job was to do, like, the cleaning, like, mopping, you know, making sure the containers are clean, all that shit. And, she was like, you know what? I open tomorrow. Don't worry about closing the containers, and we can go early. Thank you so much, Sono, for 6 months.
And I was like, are you sure? Like, I don't mind doing that. And she was like, no, I want us to leave early. Like, we just won't worry about that. And that's something that sometimes would happen, like, with my other boss. So I was like, okay, if you're sure. And then the next day, she didn't do that. Then she went, I closed with Adrian, and she didn't do any of her responsibilities. So obviously, I was kind of friends with my assistant manager. And my assistant manager knew that this girl was weird. And also, the assistant manager knew that she was trying to steal the assistant manager's position from the assistant manager. So of course, when the assistant manager asked me about it, I was like, this is literally what happened. You've closed with me before. I'm not lazy. Like, I've done this a million times. And she was like, okay, like, yeah. That sounds right, so. But then my assistant manager quit, and so did my friend that I worked with, who was, like, actually my friend. And then it would have just been me and my horrible boss and then that girl. That would have been, like, it. Those were the other, like, full-time staff. That was it. So I was like, I can't fucking work here. And the assistant manager got a job. And then the girl that I worked, that recommended me for the job got another job. And so three different people said that they could get me jobs at other places. So then I was like, oh, I'll quit and get one of those jobs at the other places. I did not get hired at any of those other places. Instead, I was unemployed for 2 months. But during that unemployment is when I started streaming. And now we're here. So honestly, it worked out. Sometimes a bad moment in your life is what leads to a really good moment in your life. But I was not doing good. I was not okay when I worked at that job. Mentally, I was doing bad. Hi, Ragnar. Management is a position that doesn't need to exist. That is given too much pressure. Honestly, yeah, I could see that take. When I worked retail, I was really underqualified boss who only got the job because previous boss had a breakdown. The assistant manager was caught stealing. So he's paranoid that whenever staff members performed well, he's maybe trying to replace him. So he constantly put us down and treated us like shit. Holy fuck, that's crazy. Ooh. The first time she did not get hired at another location. No, I did not. It was a bummer. It was a sad day for me. But also happy because now I'm on Twitch. So, living. Woo! Woo! Yeah, I pray basically that I never have to go back. Yes, thumbnail pics coming right away. Finishing up my makeup. And I'll take the. And then, big already. At this stage, can anyone guess who it's gonna be? Based off of this makeup look and eye color? Oh, you stream Pappy. I like you. Every time I clean out my list, you are a sure stay. Aw, thank you, Ragnar! Even though I bully you, you bully back. Alright, Ragnar, this is a bully relief. So, what happens? Girl from Hotel Transylvania? That's a good guess. I like that guess. Betty Boop? I like that guess too. No, I'm not supposed to say. Were you on TikTok first or Twitch? I was on Twitch first. I started casually Twitch streaming like 4 years ago while I was working at another job. That I finally got, because I started unemployed and then I eventually did get another job. And then, I went full-time, I think 2.5, maybe 3 years ago. But that was also just because of the circumstance where I kind of made a deal with my roommates, where I would do all the cleaning and they would pay extra on my rent, so I was paying, like, really cheap amounts of rent and just cleaning a lot. And then, that just kind of, like, scaled with time. So, it worked out. Tingle from Zelda. Beautiful guess. Love that. Oh, I'm so excited. Okay. Thumbnail pics. All right, what kind of poses should I do? Yeah, like a... All right. I'm liking the green eyes now that I've gotten used to them. Same. They actually look really good. Among Us imposter. Love that. Okay, I'm just gonna turn all this shit off of here. For a second. Thank you guys for all the follows today. Very cool. Oh, I should spray my face. Oh wait, no, I need to highlight first. I'll do that after. Cringing, because so the story's cringy. That's a good idea. That's a good- thank you, Zodi. You're such a good egg. A good egg. Alright. Maybe I'll move the mic away. You can't hear me because I moved the my fucking dumbass bitch. This dumbass bitch. All right, well, I didn't realize my audio was so good. The first one is the best one. I need to do it again. Okay. What else can I do here? Maybe I don't know what else spaces to pull. Hold on. The story time where I talk about my first boyfriend, so it needs to be like a maybe like a Alright, I think we got it. Let me know if you want me to take in more, Zodi. Let me know. But I think we got it. You guys get to see me cut a wig today, too, which is very cool. I'm so excited for the YouTube video. You guys better watch it. Can you use the fourth one? Sending thumb in a minute? Alright. Good deal, coming right the way. Alright. Woo! Oh, I wonder once I get the wig on if you guys will guess it. We'll see. I bet you won't. Oh, watch it? Good, Dr. Bad Days. Good. It's like a story time video. And I feel bad that I didn't get to watch it beforehand, Zodi, but I will make sure to give you lots of good praise. I don't think anyone... I don't think they will, but maybe. Sometimes a shot in the dark is the correct shot. An anime character? I'll give you a hint. I'll give you one hint. It's a video game character. I won't say what video game because it might make it too easy to guess. But it is a video game character from a video game, and it is a side character. Ah, Rotten Pappy wearing a wig. How did you know? Good guesses, good guesses. Little more obscure though. Little more obscure than where you're going. The demon from Hereditary! How'd you know? That's a joke, by the way. I am joshing you! That holder hurt? No. It's like a hairnet, but like it's slightly tighter at the base, but does not hurt. Hold on. I don't know if I want to listen. Probably not. Alright. Wig cutting time! Excuse me, miss. Okay, I see. Could we work? I wonder if I have to use my other. What the fuck is up? Oh yeah, this will work. Okay. Alright. Any guesses now? Oh, this would be perfect for Raven from Titans. But I'm gonna be cutting it, so it won't be perfect for her anymore. Knives Chow. Good guess. Not correct guess, but a good guess. Pretty. I look pretty. Okay.
gonna fuck this pig up, bitch. Getting it shit rocked. Shit. Yeah. I'm two of them. I forgot to wear my bunny ears while I was doing that. Alright, I'm done. Can you guess this character? No, I'm just kidding. I'm so funny. I laugh every time. Yo. Them. Okay. Say goodbye. You? You can guess if you want. Got a lyric? Bye, Essen! My fan house subscribers probably know. So if you're a fan of the fan, I tip my hat to you. By the way, Fanhouse is a service, kind of like OnlyFans, but minus the. Where I'll post pictures of cosplay, outtakes, all kinds of things. And pay $7 a month and see what's up. Very cool. So definitely check that out if that's something. You're gonna feel stupid? You might not. I'm not even sure that everyone here knows the character. Or will recognize it, so. But maybe. How old is the game? Retro. I'll say it's an N64 game. Chopping away. I find out, I'm so excited. I'm pumped. I think this is. The city now? Sick! You're all done with the- Yay! Alright, I'll publish it shortly. Thank you so much, Zodi. You're the best! Best boy! Yeah, we're gonna upload that in a momento. Not on this one. Definitely needs to be. I'll bring pizza, guys. A generous king, thank you. whenever Zodi says he's going to the city, it reminds me of Harvest Moon. Not Friends of Mineral Town. Harvest Moon, Wonderful Life. When they go to the town, they're like, I'm going to the city, and they're just going to Friends of Mineral Town.
Sneaky hair caught you.
Hiding in the corners, okay? Crazy trend. If you know the character. Know this song, but I can't. Dream last night that I cosplayed as that girl from Love, Death and Robots. You know the one? Cool girl with the lipstick smeared on the side. My reference picture really quick. Episode Mary Elizabeth Winstead? Yes, I do. Love, Death, and Robots is pretty good. There are some kind of darker episodes, though, and, like, themes. So, like, if that's not something you're into, I don't recommend it. But that is. Like, if you like Black Mirror and shit like that, I think you'd like.
Believe it or not, someone just DM'd me with it.
No way. I figured someone might get it. I forgot to spray my fucking face. Oh, and I forgot to highlight.
Shit!
Great job, people already know. Yay! People are figuring it out! Huh. Alright, we're not done. Fucking eyes. Contacts, that would literally be fucking nightmare. Alright. Cutting. Might have to take the wig off to cut this bit. Wow. Face ID isn't working. Guess eye color matters. Ding, 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 ding. Yoshi music. Who gave it the right? Is there a rule for four for every character? Even Captain Crunch has rule 34. Captain fucking Crunch! And I had the mistake of looking at it. Don't do it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. You don't want to think about Captain Crunch fucking every time you hear or think about Captain Crunch, which should be twice a day, at least, minimum. So, don't ruin your twice a day Captain Crunch moments by looking it up. Not have fun. It is not poggers. I think I'm needed to go get my mannequin. I'm gonna do that. I'll be right back. Also, check my pants. Give me 2 seconds. Looking. She's a little scary looking. No face. Need to cut the rest of this wig. In a mannequin head. I'm an egg. Not a styrofoam. Ooh. I'll figure it out. I'm gonna go turn my straightener on. See. Bad dream. Very cute.
Fuck it. Alright, Captain Crunch has confirmed King Commander. He's missing. What? Has Captain Crunch been fucking lying to us this whole time? Not even an actual cat. This has ruined my day. This has ruined my day. This knowledge will haunt me. I don't really have a method for this. I don't really get it. So I'm just gonna. Captain America isn't a real captain either?
I think you know someone.
Help. I just realized why I don't drink energy drinks.
Guys, I have an idea first. I have an idea. I have a very good idea. Will you help me out with something? Help. I want to make Scott Pilgrim vs. the World Iceberg. So if any big fans have any ideas, let me know. Because I think we'll make it together and then I'll make an iceberg. An iceberg? Right now, on YouTube, if you look up, like, the blank iceberg, so, like, there's a Cartoon Network iceberg, there's a Mario 64 iceberg, and it just talks about different things, subjects.
However, you are all smart and puppy as a cosplay god.
Thank you, Beer Good! And so, yeah, so icebergs have been really popular lately. And I haven't seen a Scott Pilgrim vs. the World one. I found, like, one of them, but it was very, like, they didn't have a lot of topics on there. And I already have some really good ideas as to what to put on it. So I think it'd be fun to make you guys and then make no nothing, so I'd be no help, but it sounds super dope. I'm excited. I do know some stuff. I'm gonna finish reading the comics, I think. I'm gonna try.
On the top of the berg, one of the doormen was Jesse from My Babysitter is a Vampire.
Ooh, I don't think that would be on the top. I think that would be a little lower down. I don't think that's a commonly known fact. It goes from most common knowledge to least common knowledge. That's a good one. Being part, Scott is shitty. Yeah, Scott. See, we're already coming up with ideas. We're like, and also, usually icebergs include theories, so I want to do, like, I want to include some on it and stuff. I'm actually really pumped. Like, I've been thinking about this. Because I've been, like, obsessed with iceberg videos. What, Hive Train? Thank you, Sloth, for giving that sub to Ramona! And,
Damn!
Yeah, I've been watching so many iceberg videos lately. Adventure Time, the Steven Universe iceberg, a bunch of cartoon icebergs, the Tomodachi Life iceberg I started watching today. Did you guys ever see that video of that guy who, like, cuts hair with swords? Or is that axes? I think axes. Back. Properly. Cut the rest. Global warming. A haircut with basically any sort of hair you can. Yeah. It's cool.
Put Minish Cap on the Switch, you cowards of Nintendo.
I agree. Thank you for the bit. Bits. Ah. Okay, let's see how this looks on. I think I can kind of get the ring. Okay, still not looking quite right. Okay. Fuck with it. An edit style, so people basically take stuff from a fandom, or like, so conspiracy theories, knowledge about facts of it, and they put it on an iceberg picture of an iceberg. Tip of the iceberg is the most common stuff that people know. Bottom of the iceberg is stuff that people don't know. And then videos of icebergs are people just going through the list and explaining what each thing is and what it means and the lore and all of that. Icy. Yeah. Ice.
To find out.
Thank you. Yeah.
Hello.
A cosplay and just hated the result. I wasn't super happy with my Gwen cosplay. I'm probably gonna. I know that a lot of people really liked it. So, like, obviously, no shade if you like that cosplay. I just think that the wig wasn't quite right. And I think the top could have been better. Because it also, that top is just like a little bit too big. So, I already found a top that I think would work a little bit better. So, yeah, I'm already thinking of redoing that one. I'll probably wait a little bit before I try to redo it, but and then also my Snot Girl cosplay was pretty bare bones back in the day. I mean, obviously it was my first cosplay, but I'd redo that one for sure. Maybe some better sewing. It was really good. Thank you. I'm glad that you liked it. Yeah, it's definitely like a beginner's cosplay. Also, it was kind of hard, so once I know how to sew and everything, like, I think my cosplays will be infinitely. Not to say that one was bad by any means. Start cosplaying. Have you ever joined competitions? I joined a beginner's competition, before COVID, obviously. But there was a motherfucker in that competition who had the most elaborate and crazy cosplay. Like, the rest of us were just, like, wearing clothes. And, that guy had, like, built a bunch of shit out of, like, I don't know. It was a crazy first cosplay. I can't believe that he did that as his first cosplay. It was wild. I don't even know what character it was, but it was somebody. But yeah, and then I started, my first cosplay was Snot Girl like 3 years ago. Was it three? Yeah, I think 3 years ago. And I didn't cosplay again for 2 years after that. That's when I did my Ramona Flowers cosplay. And that cosplay was really good. I put a lot of time and effort into that cosplay and a lot of forethought, and like, I'm really proud of it still. The Master Chief? No, I feel like it was like a, I don't know. It was like a very elaborate, like, I think it looked like mythological, so maybe it was a God of War character or something, but it was, or maybe what it was from, but it had like, he made a bunch of armor by hand, and it was like this like crazy stuff. It was insane, so good for him. He deserved to win for sure, but it was just like, that's what I was expecting to go up against today.
perform fellatio on him? I don't think it was Doom Guy. Please find out how much costume customization Candy Line does. She's super talented. It's cool. Her streams are really cool where she's like sewing and doing all that. She's awesome. I have so much respect and love for Candy Line. I mean, obviously, I feel like once a stream I talk about her, so. Obviously. But yeah, I love her. From Kirby's Epic Yarn. I recognize it. I think I can get away with this. Get these adjusted. I have so much fucking big hair all over me. I knew I shouldn't have worn these pants for this, but I just... Chat, why did you let me do it? No, I'm just kidding. I have no one to blame. Okay, real quick, I'm gonna fix up these little pieces. That's gonna happen in the bathroom. And then I'm gonna come back and we're gonna... Oh, that scared me. Wolf, thank you so much. Oh, here's your ASMR slurp sound, Kari. Thank you so much for the raid. Welcome in, raiders. Hi, I'm Rotten Poppy. I'm a retro variety streamer. I'm cosplaying right now, or getting into cosplay. I'm almost done. Surprise cosplay. Try to guess what character I am. At this point, we're really close to being done. No. Stop looking at me. How was Monster Hunter? How was the stream? How much you've changed just by eye color? I know, I look good though. I'm surprised. Also, I feel like I'm gonna... Okay, and then I need... This is the final piece that we need. Someone, I believe, sent these to me as a stream gift. I can't remember who. Sorry, I always forget, but thank you very much. Shorter elf ear. Okay, I need to fix the lips just a little bit. I can hydrate. On the elf. Probably a good idea because they're quite pale. Let's do that. Good idea, Doom. Okay, by now, if you don't have it, then you're not gonna get it. So, I believe Raven got it right. I don't know who else. But. It's... I'll pull a side-by-side up and...
actual...
But, get these. Great, thank you. I think I might trim the bangs up. On inspection. This would have been smarter to do with paint, actually, now that I'm thinking about it, because this is gonna come off. See? Oh wait, I can hairspray it. Never mind. Hairspray will do that. That looks good. Get my, Incredibly joined. I see Bomb Chew Alley Girl. Got it immediately. That makes me happy. That means I did it right. Congratulations to me. It was useful, Doom. I appreciate it. Normally, I hate to do. Wait, I'm doing the wrong ear. Well, guess they're all gonna look like this now. Shit. That's from Bomb Chew Rally Girl. She was so cute, right? When I saw her, I was like, I need to cosplay her. And then, now look at me. Cosplaying her. I'm proud. A proud dad. Also, I don't know if anyone noticed, but I changed my bios on everything from kind of cosplayer just to cosplayer. Cosplayer. Bitch. Cosplayer. Bitch. I cosplay. Motherfucker. Okay.
Spot on job you did, in my humble opinion. Well done.
Done. I'm happy I waited for my color contacts to get here to do this cosplay, though. I was considering doing it and keeping my brown eyes, but I think this... I'm gonna get my hairspray. I'm gonna spray the shit out of these ears. Spray. It looks really spotty, but you know what? Ew. Thank you.
you're wearing the ears. Yeah, I'm just drying them because I just sprayed hair. I'm just letting them dry for a second. That I can't not worry about the makeup coming off. A bit slippery on silicone because these. Yes. Do you want the playlist? I can send it to you. Hands are sticky. Oops. Well, I think I got hairspray in my drink. That's okay. I'm gonna drink it anyway. I don't give a shit. Here you go. Does not taste like hairspray. Fuck Zelda. Honestly, true though. I mean, but Zelda's not supposed to be like a romanceable, like, character. Like, they're supposed to be friends, which I like. Except for in, what's that other one called? Oops, I got concealer all over my hair. What's that other game called? Skyward Sword. Then she's your romance. But your romance character in Legend of Zelda typically isn't the princess, which is something I've always really liked about it. Need a BRB for 10 minutes? Sounds good, Shin. In Skyward Sword? Yeah! Zelda is the... I mean, I don't want to spoil it for you, but yes. But Zelda is your waifu for laifu in Skyward Sword. But Skyward Sword's actually pretty good. I think it gets a little more hate than it should. I mean, I think it's my least favorite Zelda game that I've played, but by no means does that make it bad. Actually, and I think, because there's the remake coming out, right? Or the re-release? And I think that'll fix a lot of the problems that people have with Skyward Sword in it. Because a lot of people just didn't like the fucking motion controls. It was like their main concern is that they just didn't like the way it controlled. So, with the Switch changing that, I think it'll actually be really good. Plus, the side quests in Skyward Sword are fucking bomb. I really like the side quests in that one. Okay, it's almost dry, but it's not quite dry. For the Switch, it's $60. I think it... Wait, is it out? Has it been out this whole fucking time? I don't know. But yeah, I think it's gonna be worth it for sure. And if it's out already, then I think it is probably worth it. I prefer motion controls. Honestly, I respect that opinion. I don't think the motion controls are that bad. In June or July? Yeah, I think it'll probably be worth it. I mean, I can't say for sure until the game's out. But I will be playing it when it's released. Probably, maybe not right when it's released, depending on my gaming schedule, but... The hate for me as well, mostly because it's a Zelda game that is not super brilliant, which is unusual, which makes it look bad in comparison, but I've heard that it's actually good. Well, if you haven't played it, then how do you know if it's brilliant or not?
Just saying,
it's pretty good. I had some really cool puzzles. There's like some really good things about it. For sure. I think Twilight Princess is one of my personal favorites. Love! Thank you. Yeah, Twilight Princess also, I think it's like unnecessary hate. I think Twilight Princess is fucking amazing. Except for the tutorial's long as fuck. Stupid long. But it's a good game. It's a really good game. And if you like, I think if you really like Ocarina of Time and you haven't given that one a fair chance, it's definitely worth it. I haven't played Zelda's Adventure.
Sloth Kappa.
What? Kirby Crystal Shards.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. On 7/6. But July 16th. Play Super Smash Bros? Yeah. I'm not like a pro player, but I do play it. Not like a goer. But I play a mean piece. Slash date. I do. I do say so much. I look like her. I'm proud! Ah! I'm okay. Almost fell. But I'm good.
Disgusting.
Alright, I'm gonna pull up a picture of the characters so that you can see her a bit better. So give me a sec. Probably the best picture of her. Okay. I was thinking of getting out of cosplay right after this, but I feel I like this cosplay so much, I don't want to take it off. I don't want to take it off. Motherfucker. Okay. I'll just save it to the desktop. Do you think I did it? Do you think I did a good job? Papa, do you like it? Come to the bomb chew alley. Motherfucker. Motherfucker. Looks great. I'm a proud father. And then when you talk to her, she does this the whole time.
Come in. Oh, is the kid collecting masks? How about it? Wanna play? For you, it's 20 rupees.
Okay. Alright, I'll say it. Min! Oh, is the kid collecting masks? How about it? Wanna play? For you? 20 rupees. For you? 20 rupees.
For you? It's $1,000,000! Get the fuck out of my
Never mind. Not $1,000,000, I'm sorry. You can play for free.
Shadow. Proud of you, child.
Yeah! For you? 20 rupees. The green haired girl who moves like that? I mean, Saria? No. No! Maybe, huh? But I know she does. Get out of my shop, you little shit! I feel like her bangs are supposed to be short. The one at the entrance. Green hair girl is a receptionist. Oh, she might also move like that, maybe. But I know Bomb Chew Girl definitely does this business. But she's sleeping when you first meet her, so that's might be why the. Or maybe she only moves like that in Ocarina of Time? In both games. Maybe I'm wrong. I'm late again? You should be sorry. Look at this. You could have seen this getting put together. How dare you? How dare? Flix, thanks for gifting those subs. Sheet. Thanks so much. Enjoy those. Best on Twitch, effectively. Here, Mega Man, here's your ASMR slurp.
They look almost the same. Oh, just the same person, probably recently.
Alright. Okay. Excuse me one moment. I'm going to fix up the YouTube video, get it ready and sent. Real quick. My first waifu! Hello, I'm waifu for laifu. Okay. I had an idea for this title of the video. I was thinking talking about my weird and dramatic middle school drama for way too long. Or what else? Multiversy. Thank you. I will hydrate. No one could have seen this coming. Some people actually guessed it. When the cosplay was closer to being done, though, of course. Of course. Okay, you guys remember that story time I did where I talked about my first boyfriend? Alright, we made it into a YouTube video. What should I call it? My middle school boyfriend is now in jail. I think he's out of jail now, but he did go to jail. Talking about my middle school boyfriend who later went to jail. Nah, I don't want to do that. Don't want to do that. Middle school. Middle school. Mr. Mick Middle School. John A. Middle School inventor. Okay. My middle school. I don't want to like clickbait like 2016. I want it to be like what? My first boyfriend. Damn it, I don't know. I had. No. He was her boyfriend in middle school, and you'll never guess what happened next. Hold on, I know what to do. I know what to do. Just need to look up some inspiration. I'm gonna yoink this title from someone else. Nah, I'm not gonna yoink it, but I'm just gonna look at some other titles of YouTube channels that I like and see what kind of titles we got. Because I remember there was like one really iconic one. Oh, like unloading middle school trauma could be like a good title. And then the thumbnail is like first boyfriend. Like, you know, unloading middle school trauma. My bad boyfriend experience from middle school. My middle school boyfriend made me cry. Boyfriend got wrong. Boyfriend gone wrong. Not clickbait. My first boyfriend in middle school scarred me. My middle school boyfriend chased me and threw muffin bits at me. Big red arrow. No, this is... No one will click on my video if I do that, I swear. In the current state of YouTube, I will get no views from doing shit like that. It needs to be like... just something basic. My weird middle school, not in all caps. Okay, caps lock was just on. Talking about middle school drama for a really long time. No. Top 5 muffin incidents. Unloading my middle school trauma. I feel like that's a good title. Unloading my middle school trauma. Doesn't say what it is. The title goes, first boyfriend? Okay. I feel like that's a good one. I would click on a video like that, I think. I'd be like, what was the middle school trauma? Who is first boyfriend? Had a guy ask me if I can write piss kink fanfiction. That's close I've got to a boyfriend. Patrick, no! Copy a ton of Mongu video title. If I do that, no one will click on it though. That does not reflect the current scope of YouTube. If I use a 2016 title, everyone will be like, this is clickbait. You know, he fucked me with a toothbrush? Nah, not gonna work this time. Loading my middle school trauma. My first boyfriend bullied me. My first boyfriend bullied me. Story time. A muffin. How my first boyfriend turned into my first bully. That's a good title, I think. How my first boyfriend turned to my first bully. I think I would click on that. I just pray that no one from school watches or asks me about this fucking video. Because I don't want them to. I honestly... it's weird, but I am more comfortable with strangers knowing stuff about my life than people I grew up with. I'm like, don't think about me. I do not exist, okay? Oh, someone's dog. Fucking dog. A dog? Dog? Hello? so Candyline, we talked about you a lot today, my beautiful friend.
Thank you. You can block your and tell your ex people, school people to piss off. I don't know if they follow me or see me, but like I do, like there's like I don't care that much, like enough to seek them out on YouTube and like find their account and fucking block them. It's, like if anyone messages me about it, I probably will just off. That's true. Like awkward. Especially like someone I was like kind of friends with is like, what? Who was that? And I'm like, don't fucking ask. Don't fucking ask me questions, bitch. Do you like it? I'm her. I think the lip color could.
Yeah, try the.
You think that calling him my first bully is too mean? I mean, we were 12, so I don't, like, care that much. Like, I don't, I feel like we can forgive a 12-year-old's actions.
First boyfriend bullied me with muffins. We use definitive, oh, wait. I don't know.
I got blue, people from my school started coming up to me. It became very weird considering the videos I make. I had, like, a couple people,
I think the worst was when my cousin took a screenshot of one of my TikToks. It was like, your TikTok thought? And I was like, don't fucking look at me. Bitch! Don't fucking look at me!
Other than that, it's been okay. I'm gonna call him a bully? Okay, I think I will, because he threw rocks at me and called me a whore. So I think that's fair. I don't hold it against him now, like, you know. It's fine. I don't have a, you know, I'm not out here trying to make him enemies. I left his name out of the story. So it's not like I'm, like, trying to ruin his life or anything. I can call him a bull. Okay. I'm just, like, nervous. You know, but he didn't kind of bully me. Okay.
You got slut shamed by your own cousin?
Yeah.
Tell me about it!
Candy Lion! Thank you! 5 months of having a juicy, thick IQ. I can't believe it's been that long.
I love you, friend. There's something. Hold on. Not with the colored contacts in. Not with the colored contacts in.
We have a count going of how many times I've had to fucking pull shit out of my eye. We're okay. I think we're okay. It was just a hair, like, pulled it in. Okay, we're good.
Scary.
And now let me make a description and all that, and then you can go watch the video and find out how my boyfriend bullied me with Muffin. Featuring Muffin.
Zubbler punching Treasure Girl in the back.
What fucking happens? Okay, so what should I put here at the tags? I think probably the. Right. Story time? Boyfriend? Middle school? Middle school drama. Trauma. I did not spell it right. How do you spell trauma? Trauma. Oh, okay. Bullying. First boyfriend. How me and my first boyfriend broke up. Gone wrong. Okay, I think that's good. And then I need to take a description out of one of my other videos. This is Patrick! Thank you so much for subscribing, you're such a sweetie! Hope you enjoyed those emotes. Fun fact, those are actually the best emotes on Twitch objectively, according to the inventor of Twitch, John A. Twitch, who invented Twitch and says that. And that's just true. That's just a true thing that not a lot of people know about, because I never bring it up, ever. Story time. At the end screen. Foster check.
Okay.
Curious, because I don't know how this video ends. Yeah, it just ends. Just ends. Okay, that's good. By the way, I found out... So, YouTube Analytics lets you know, like, where most of your views are coming from, and, like, if there's another view that you're getting recommended, or if you're on a playlist or anything. And someone put me on a playlist titled Cringe. And the weird thing is, all the other videos on the playlist are in, like, Korean, I think? And... except for mine, which is just randomly in there. Hog. 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 And it's actually one of my best videos. Like, one of my it's my Ramona Flowers Ubisoft stream. Videos just in the cringe. I mean, they might not necessarily think it's cringy. I don't know, but I was like, what? What? Oh, but who did that? You bitch. You bitch. All my Korean friends are laughing at you. You're so kind of me on TikTok. Always enjoying your content on there. So considering this is my way of saying thank you. What? Oh, you're so nice. Okay, so I got the... Okay. Okay, then I'll leave a note. If you went to middle school with me, no, you didn't. All right, there we go. Now, if anyone recognizes me and sees this video, if it gets a million views and everyone's like, Poppy, I can say that they didn't go to school with me. It says so in the description. And they're lying because no one went to school with me because I'm an AI. And that was a fake story created by my programmers. That's what I'm gonna say. So back me up. If that happens, back me up. category. Let's see. Switch it off of game. Into. Or should I put it in comedy? I'm gonna put it in comedy. Fuck it. It's funny. We all laughing together. Alright. Okay. Now this video is ready to go. She's good. I'm gonna hit save. All that shit is there. Set it as public. Boom. Done. Save. Video is public, guys. Copy that link. Add it to the end. Alright. Now she's ready. I can't believe it's already like 2:47. We haven't even done Bob Ross yet. I haven't even done Bob Ross yet. Hydrate, you got it, Patrick. You're a good person who deserves good things, except for the cookie. The cookie's mine. Cookie demon. Something different about you? It's my contacts. I'm watching a Let's Play series called RPG of Yike. The character is named Bella and looks like you and could possibly- Oh, that's good to know. The cringe part is me in that video! Oh my god, yeah, you are in that video! Maybe it's candy- yeah. You know what? Sure. Candyline, how could you do this to me? None of my other videos are sorted into cringe. And now look what happens. Okay, new YouTube video is up, guys. Please watch it. I'm gonna go take pictures of this cosplay for a few minutes. And then we're gonna come back and do the Bob Ross MS Paint speed paint. So please go watch it. I'm gonna also put out an alert in the Discord. You get an alert in the Discord. Please do not get mad at me. New YouTube video. My ex dumping middle school trauma on you. Hopefully no one in my life gives me shit for talking about my life events. Because that makes me nervous. Alright, pow. Send it out. Send it out. Okay. So I had to tell you, cosplayers were doing a thing on Twitter where they're Googling themselves, and I did. And your Twitch came up when you Google me? No way! Google can't tell us apart! We are the same person. Shit. Sorry, Candyline. I did not mean to steal. You're an Ocarina of Time NPC? Yes, I am. And I'm proud of it. Okay. Go watch my new YouTube video. I'll be back in a few minutes. I'm gonna go take some pictures of this and, like, let everyone else know that I have a new YouTube video up as well. Then we'll continue with a bop. Man. One day I will stream Tomodachi Life. Even if it's just once, for one short stream, my life will feel complete. I will have completed the circle of life! This was a very good stream. I had fun today. Have that up to you soon. I plan on seeing you Sunday. Yay! Pog! Pog, 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 pog. Your cosplay's top quality? Thank you. Look at this. I'm so happy. That took forever. Dude, I literally don't care. Literally, you could let it could take another 2 months. I would not complain. How could I possibly complain? You're sending me a DS for free. Send it whatever you want. Leave it. Send it to me and leave a big footprint on it. And a note that says, fuck you. And I'll still be like, thank you so much. So much. This is great. Why don't you TikTok chat? The ultimate way to get bitches. All right, let's check this out. Hold on. Oh, was I looking the wrong direction? Okay, sorry. I'm just really proud. I'm happy I did this. Nice. It's the girl who has weird feelings towards Gordons. Oh, wait. Is it the Goron that she lets play for free? I thought it was the Zora. Could have been the Goron. Like, you play for free. I love fish people. Or was it Gore? I love people with frogs. This is Abigail's mom, actually. Her real mom. People suspect she has a different dad. It's actually a different mom. She, too, is a rock-eating girl. Goron has to pay extra. Oh, okay. Never mind. Right about it being... Oh, wait. Weird feelings towards Goron still counts as... Yeah, that is weird. That is weird. It's weird. Whoops. I'm happy. Should I dress up like this every day? Get a job at a bowling alley? Do you think I should try to get a job at a bowling alley looking like this? And then I'll just be like really cryptic in the interview? Like, I promise not to sleep on work. I won't sleep during the job. I won't let fish people play for free. I really like you. I'm a huge fan of Gorons. I
they just kick me out. They're like, what the fuck? I have 5 outfits of the same color. I totally don't wear the same shirt every day. Man. Yeah. You think that's weird enough to get kicked out of a bowling alley? Even up? That's true. The bowling alley in my hometown had a sign on the door. This, I actually loved this. It had a sign on the door for a little while that said, "All staff must moonwalk out of the bathroom." Can you imagine working? And your boss is like, ah! Like, every time you leave the bathroom, you didn't moonwalk! You're like, what's with the costume?
Costume.
Just gaslight every fucking customer who comes in. What costume? Why do you got those pointy ears on? Just act like I never noticed that my ears are. These are my ears. These look pointy. Never noticed that before. God. That and tear up. All employees must do the worm leaving work. They like write you up if they see you leave the bathroom without moonwalking. Seriously, one more time, I see you leave the bathroom moonwalking. I'm gonna have to put in a formal complaint. Ew. Oh, it's a birth defect. That'd be funny. That would be good content. I would like to film. One day, I will become a menace to public. Better fucking move. Steve, you didn't do the funky chicken out of your way to the cafeteria. There you go. Third time this week. Greetings from Mexico. Hi! We used to live close to a bowling alley and went to play pinball a lot. Place is another, it's like another universe. In what sense? What sense? Greetings from Ecuador. Hello! Yeah. Bowling alley in my hometown was pretty cool. I liked it. Except for the time that I smashed my phone. I did smash my phone in the bowling alley. I went bowling. Phone was in my pocket. Threw a bowling ball. Phone fell out of my pocket. Phone hit floor, same time as this bowling ball hit the floor. Shattered. Absolutely shattered. Day before I had a flight. I had a flight in the morning. Phone shattered. Yeah. Yeehaw! From Texas! Sloth! The bowling alley constantly broke, and the staff don't know how to pour a pint properly. Oh, that's a bummer. I don't think I ever drank at the bowling alley. Oh wait, no, I think I ordered a drink at the bowling alley. I think I got a Mike's Hard Lemonade. I don't speak Spanish at all. Sorry. English only. Our local bowling alley was robbed at gunpoint. Who would rob a bowling alley? I know where the money is. In the bowling alley. What? Which is crazy, since I'm in the UK, what? You get a gun. Okay, imagine, you get a gun in the UK. Hold on a fucking second. You get a gun in the UK, where it is hard to get a gun. So you jump through hoops, all kinds of hoops, to finally get a gun. And the first thing you do is rob a bowling alley.
a bowling alley. Finally, I have a gun. It is going to be very difficult for people in this area to fight me back with this gun. What am I going to do with it? Rob a bowling alley.
What did I tune back into?
Someone who desperately needs money robs a bowling alley. But in order to get a gun in a place like the UK, I assume that you would probably have to buy a gun for a lot of money from a really sketchy person, right? You'd probably have to go through several sketchy people, I imagine, to get said gun. And pay money to get said gun. And then you finally get said gun, and they were like, bowling alley is my first target. Maybe they used to work there. Maybe they used to work there and they made them moonwalk out of the bathroom every time that they exited the bathroom. So they were like, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna get a gun and I'm gonna rob the bowling alley. Teach them about moonwalking out of the bowling alley. I'll teach them to tell me to moonwalk out of the bowling alley. Damn. I get revenge for all the 7-10s. Damn. Just saying, if you're gonna get a gun illegally, like, buy the fucking bowling alley. Ours are easily identified when they moonwalked away out of habits. Get your gun at no price at all. But even so, you think the kind of person who knows someone who could get them a gun for free would be like first target bowling alley, you know? It's just weird. It's just weird. Like, yes, there obviously are circumstances where it would happen, but it's weird. It's still weird, guys. It's a weird choice. That's a weird choice. I love your outline. Thank you.
Don't know what that means.
My only thought is that they would think it would be something no one would ever expect. Yeah, I guess that's true. They'd be like, the bowling alley won't expect to get robbed. So it's probably easier to rob them. Yeah, actually, my friend got robbed. Well, not friend. A girl that I worked with got robbed at gunpoint at a Subway sandwich shop. But, like, people can get guns here. Like, it's not super uncommon that someone might do that. And she was also working at, like, a Subway in a very, like, sketchy area. So, that's scary. I asked her what she did. She was like, I just gave him the money. And I was like, that makes sense. Then he left. So, Vince places only like, yeah, that's true. If they think that they're gonna get robbed, but the bowling alley, see, the bowling alley might be the smart, maybe they were big brain, maybe it was big IQ, maybe they watched the stream and they think, definitely thought about it. He didn't want the sandwich, he just wanted the money from the register, like a, you know, someone very addicted to drugs. And high. So. Got a gun, ran in, kind of just got the money.
Oh, it is. You know.
Oh, it is. I'm gonna risk harm. Going to jail for $120, maybe? Yeah. Too literally, they wanted to steal some of the priceless works. 23 minus 10 equals Friday the 13th. Where's the Friday? How does that equal Friday? Doesn't equal Friday. Also, hi, Toast! Bad place to rob? Ever had a bowling ball thrown at you? Wait a minute, yeah. Up, up, up. Yeah, it's just for moderation purposes so that people aren't saying inappropriate or TOS stuff in the chat. That's why. It's not like, I know it's like kind of shitty, but it's just got to be that way. Also, then everyone can participate. They got away with it, so maybe we're the idiots for doubting. They got away with it. Damn. I wonder how much money they even got, though. Was it worth it? Was it worth it? Oh. I guess if they got away with it, that'd be considered worth it. Grandma's paint skills are great. Thank you, Brutalist. I appreciate that. I very much appreciate that. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Alright, guys. This is where we're gonna end the stream today.